And I can promise you two things. I can promise you. One thing I can promise you is that in order for you to learn this stuff, you have to unlearn everything that you knew before. And the second thing that I want to promise you is that the things that you want will happen. It is guaranteed. But you've got to keep with the work because it does take time. Depending on how good a child you were, I was a very good child. Depending on how good a child you were, meaning, were you a child who listened to the grown-ups and did exactly what you were told and were so observant that you learned everything, you learned the expressions, you could tap into the feelings, you could know what they were thinking. If you were that kind of an empathic child, then you picked up a lot of garbage along the way. To the extent that you picked up garbage, it is going to take time for the results of the work that we do in Law of Attraction to pay off for you. Because unlearning and then learning are hard. I remember when I was 10 years old, I was a tennis fanatic. And every day after school, I would go and practice tennis, and I would practice serving the ball. And when my mother eventually got me a tennis lesson from a tennis pro, I discovered that I had learned everything completely wrong. And this teacher was helping me to fix things, and it was so much harder because I had to unlearn. My body had already learned. So here's the thing, and I was teaching this in the Unlimited 365 group, which is a small group of people who are 100%, more than 100% committed to their personal development and change, that they show up every day for themselves. In the Unlimited 365 group, I was sharing with them that a habit is something that you do without having to pay conscious attention to make decisions about how you're going to do it. That's what a habit is. I remember the first time I gave my son a knife in his hand to cut chicken. He was aware of everything. He was so conscious about the size of the cubes he was cutting, how he was positioning the knife. And now he, no attention required. Because each one of those things that he was doing when he first picked up the knife was a decision. But when you make the same decision about the same thing over and over again, then you get to a stage where your mind says, "Oh, I know what the decision is already. You don't need to make a new decision." And that's when you go off on autopilot. This is why we can drive cars without paying attention to them. This is why you can vacuum the house without paying attention, because you've already made those decisions about how you're going to vacuum. Think about Think about it. I find it hilarious and so interesting that when I vacuum, I use it the same way. I will put it under this chair this way. I'll move that chair away. I will pick up this thing. All the same actions. Why? Because I made those decisions long ago when I moved into the house, that this is how I was going to clean my house. Now, I have made those decisions the first couple of times when I was vacuuming my house. Now I don't need to make those decisions anymore. My body already knows what to do. My mind already knows what instructions to give my hands to get the job done. There's no new decision making required. And so when we first start the 40-day workout, when we first start to become someone who does the pre-paving, who does the appreciation, who asks the universe for help every time there's something to do, we become someone who looks at the blessings, the tiny things that we take for granted every day, and we start appreciating them because we feel blessed by them. And we become someone who spends at least 2 minutes in a visualization that takes us high on the emotional scale. Well then, when we do it enough times, it becomes automatic. And so when it becomes automatic, that is when everything in your life is going to change. That is when you will become a nicer person to yourself as well as to the world. You will be nicer to yourself and you'll be nicer to other people because you will become so conscious of where you are on the emotional scale and the momentum that you're creating that you will start paying attention to every thought that you think. Because remember, every thought that you think is a prayer. That is the basis of the entire book called How to Pray So That God Listens. So here I am to tell you that the thing that you need to do is repetition. Repetition with attention. Repetition without attention takes way longer for us to learn things that way. But repetition with focused attention, we learn really quickly.